Listening Library presents Katie Kazoo Switcheroo, Book 16, Bad Rap, by Nancy Krulik. Read for you by Ann Bobby. Chapter 1. And I dream of you when I awake. Suzanne Locke sang out wildly as she danced around her friend Katie Carew's room. When I awake, Katie joined in, using her hairbrush like a microphone. Katie's cocker spaniel, Pepper, howled loudly. Katie giggled. That's it, Pepper, sing along. That was Dreams by the Bayside Boys, Joey G, the radio DJ, announced as the song came to an end. Thanks for spending your Sunday afternoon with me, Joey G, on Cherrydale's number one radio station. I think Dreams is my favorite Bayside Boys song, Suzanne told Katie. She flopped down on the bed and tried to catch her breath. I love every song on their CD. It's like they're singing just to me, Katie sighed. Hey, that rhymes, Suzanne exclaimed. You sound just like T-John. Katie smiled. T-John did all the raps on the Bayside Boys songs. He was so awesome. Suzanne had given her a real compliment. I can't decide which of the Bayside Boys I like the best, Suzanne said. She looked up at the poster on Katie's bedroom wall. I mean, Fizzy's got that amazing braided hair, and T-John dances really well, and I love his sunglasses. But when Ace sings, I get all tingly. I'm glad he's the lead singer. Katie shrugged. I like Spike the best. He seems really nice, and I like the way he spikes his hair up in the front. Suzanne laughed. That's just like you, Katie. Hardly anybody likes Spike the best. That's okay, Katie told her. I think he's cool. Sure he is, Suzanne agreed. All the Bayside Boys are cool. I've got a special surprise for all you Bayside Boys fans out there, Joey G suddenly announced. Instantly, Katie and Suzanne stopped talking. They stared anxiously at the radio. The Bayside Boys are coming to Cherrydale, the DJ said. Ah! Suzanne screamed. Dreams do come true! Shh, Katie told her. We have to find out when. Suzanne quieted down. Ace, Fizzy, Spike, and T-John will be at the Cherrydale Arena this Saturday night to tape a cable TV special. Tickets will go on sale tomorrow morning at 9 a.m., but only at the arena's box office. You've got to be there in person to score your seats. Oh, wow, Suzanne exclaimed. Katie, we have to get tickets for that show. We can't, Katie told her sadly. What? Are you crazy? Of course we can. I have allowance money saved up, Suzanne said. So do I, said Katie. But money isn't the problem. Then what is? Suzanne asked her. Tomorrow is Monday, Katie reminded her best friend. We'll be in school at 9 o'clock. Tears welled in Suzanne's eyes. You're right. This is awful. She brightened suddenly. Unless. Unless what? Katie asked excitedly. Unless your mom can get the tickets for us. She doesn't go to school. That's true, Katie agreed. Let's go ask her. The girls raced down the stairs at top speed. Pepper ran after them, barking at their heels. Mom! Katie shouted. I need you! It's an emergency, Suzanne added. Mrs. Carew came running out of the kitchen. What's wrong, girls? She asked nervously. The Bayside Boys are coming to Cherrydale, Suzanne blurted out. But we'll be in school tomorrow morning when the tickets go on sale, Katie explained. They're going to sell out, Suzanne said. You have to go and get tickets for us, the girls finished together. Mrs. Carew took a deep breath. Oh, she said. Is that all? Is that all? Suzanne gasped. Mrs. Carew, this is the most important thing that's ever happened to us. Katie's mother laughed. Mom, tickets go on sale tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. Can't you stop at the Cherrydale Arena and buy them for us? Katie pleaded. Mrs. Carew shook her head. Sorry, girls. I have to be at work early tomorrow morning. I won't have time to get the tickets. How about Dad? Katie asked hopefully. He's working too, Mrs. Carew reminded Katie. Suzanne thought for a moment. My dad's out of town, but my mom will be around. We can ask her to get the tickets. She raced for the door. Where are you going? Katie asked her. Home! I have to talk to my mom! Suzanne exclaimed. Why don't you just call her from here? Katie asked. Suzanne shook her head. This is a big favor. I want to ask her in person. 10 minutes later, Katie's phone rang. I'll get it, Katie shouted, hoping it was Suzanne. Hello? Katie said into the phone. It was Suzanne, and she didn't sound happy. My mom has to take Heather to some dumb old baby music class, Suzanne told Katie angrily. She didn't think getting tickets for the Bayside Boys concert was an important enough reason for her to miss it. But it is important, Katie said. So important. I know that, and you know that, Suzanne sighed. But my mom doesn't know that. I can't believe the Bayside Boys are going to be right here in Cherrydale and we won't get to see them. It's just not fair. Katie and Suzanne stayed on the phone for a little while, but neither girl said much. There wasn't anything to say. The fact was, they weren't going to the Bayside Boys concert. And that really stunk. Chapter 2. The next morning on the playground, everyone was talking about the Bayside Boys concert. I can't believe my mom wouldn't let me miss school to go get tickets, Jessica Haynes moaned. I know what you mean, Zoe Cantor agreed. This is so sad. Even my big sister Lacey wants to go to that concert, Emma Weber said. But she's got a math test this morning. There's no way my parents would let her miss that to go buy tickets. Katie sighed. I really wanted to see Spike up close. It's just plain dumb, Suzanne told the girls. What is? Katie asked her. It's dumb that the tickets went on sale today. All the Bayside Boys fans are kids, and kids are in school on Monday mornings, Suzanne explained. Hey, that's right, Mandy Banks exclaimed. You know, I bet the concert won't sell out, at least not this morning. Katie's face brightened. That means we can go get tickets after school. I was thinking the same thing, Suzanne agreed. Meet me here after your band practice. Okay, but I have to go back to my classroom and sign out with Mr. Guthrie before I can go home, Katie reminded her. That's all right, Suzanne said, but hurry, we don't want to miss out on getting tickets. Katie turned to Emma W. Do you want to come with us? She asked, not wanting to leave her new friend out. Emma frowned. I can't. It's my turn to help my mom with the twins this afternoon. Oh, Katie replied. That's too bad. But maybe... Before Katie could finish her sentence, Becky Stern came running onto the playground. Well, not running, actually. She was doing cartwheels across the yard. Hey, everyone! Becky greeted the girls as she landed right beside them. I have the best news. We already know, Suzanne told her. The Bayside Boys are coming to Cherrydale. Katie and I are going to buy tickets this afternoon. Forget it, Becky told her. They'll be sold out by then. There are already 1,000 people lined up outside the Cherrydale Arena waiting for the ticket booth to open. I heard it on the news. Katie frowned. So much for great ideas. If the show's going to sell out, why are you so happy? Emma W. asked Becky. Becky smiled. Because I already have my tickets, she told her. That's impossible, Suzanne exclaimed. They don't go on sale for another 20 minutes. I didn't buy my tickets, Becky boasted. I got them for free. How did you do that? Zoe Cantor asked. The Bayside Boys record all their CDs at a studio in Atlanta.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.